Hello friends, welcome to my channel Electrical Master. This video I am going to complete explain about how VFD is working. If you are visiting my channel first time, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon. Let's go to the video. And these are the content. Today we are going to discuss what is VFD, how VFD is working, and block diagram of VFD. Discuss about VFD uses in industrial, advantages of VFD. First we will start with what is VFD. We know VFD means variable frequency drive or variable speed drive. Mostly VFD used for it is one of the starter to start the induction motor, and also the main purpose of VFD is to control the speed of the motor. That is the main purpose of VFD. And VFD can also control the speed of the motor during start and stop cycle as well as throughout the run cycle. It means using the VFD, we know we can control the speed of the motor. That controlling also we can use from while starting the motor and stopping the motor, and over the operation also we can easily control the speed. Whatever the speed we need, we can easily control through the VFD starters. And VFD also control the torque and the direction of the motor. So motors torque also we can easily control using this VFD drives. And also that motor rotation, either clockwise or anti-clockwise direction also we can easily control without changing the cable. Normally the direction changing, we need to reverse the cable connection in the motor terminal, but using the VFD drive just to give the command to easily change the rotation. So this is the VFD. Now we will see how VFD is working. We know three phase induction motor, well, the starting current of three phase induction motor is 6 times of full load current. So we want to reduce this that induced current, we need starter. The main purpose of starter is to reduce in the starting current. There are different types of starters available in the market. A DOL, star delta, auto transformer, soft starter, and VFD. The other different from other starter than VFD is, VFD you can also control the starting current and also through the motor speed entire operation we can easily control. That is the beauty of VFD. How VFD is controlling the speed of the motor? We know the speed relation of the induction motor is NS equal to 120 S by P. It means the synchronous speed is directly proportional to the frequency and indirectly proportional to the pole. So we want to control the speed of the motor, either we want to increase or decrease the frequency or increase or decrease the number of poles. So then increasing poles is very difficult compared to the increasing the frequency. That's why we are choosing the VFD to easily we can adjust the frequency of the motor to control the speed of the motor. So you, based on this technique only VFD is working. Detail how VFD is working we can easily understand from the block diagram of VFD. You can see here this is the block diagram of VFD. There are three parts involved in this VFD. One is the rectification, another one is filtering, and third is the inverting circuit. You can see here normal AC power we are connected to the VFD rectification part. We know normal this rectifier, bridge rectifier, it's converting AC into DC. That DC will be connected to the filters, because this rectifier converting DC is it's not having pure DC. It is combined with noise and harmonics will present. For filtering the harmonics, we are using the capacitor. So after the capacitor, we are receiving the pure DC. That DC will be connected to the inverting circuit. Here, inverting circuit, we are using the IGBTs. IGBTs is the one of the transistor. The IGBTs having the switching loss is very less compared to the other transistor, MOSFET and BJT. That's why we are using IGBT transistor in the inverting section. Here, that IGBTs, they are giving the input through the controller using the PWM technique. PWM means pulse width modulation. Using this PWM technique, we can easily control the output frequency of the VFT. You can see here, this is the VFT output waveform. See, this is a sine wave. This is the number of cycles. For example, if it is 50 hertz, means it is 50 cycles per second. You can see here, each cycle will be different width. Some cycles having larger, some cycle having less. That is the PWM input. Suppose we want to increase the frequency, just we can increase this width of the cycle to increase the frequency. For decreasing, same like reduce the width of the cycle. In this, using this PWM technique, we can easily control the output of the VFT and also output of the motor speed also we can easily control. Now we will see how VFT uses in the industry. The practically how the VFT is working in plant. We know the main purpose of VFT is to control the speed of the motor. Here let's consider a water treatment plant. Normally we know water treatment plant means the treated water we are storing in some places, some storage tank. That same water will be used for the other purpose of the plant in the this side. So suppose here I am using instead of a VFT drive, some other DOIL starter or some other starter I am using means it can that is also easy while starting time reducing the starting current. But whenever the storage tank if it is full but my output requirement will be less, that time I can't control the flow of the motor. Either I need to switch off the motor only to control the water flow. For using VFT drive, I can easily control the speed of the motor. For example, here the water is now it is coming to the storage tank. Now it is flowing to the plant other areas. Suppose my requirement in the plant area will be less. So I want to reduce the flow. Just I give the command to reduce the speed of the pump. Then pump speed will be reduced. Then flow also automatically will reduce. So the storage tank will receiving water will be less. So it's automatically control the storage tank through the VFT drives. See the other example. This is one of the example for the plant cooling fan system. For example, here I am using the temperature sensor. My requirement is whenever the temperature is increased up to 80 Fahrenheit, at the time the VFT drive will give full speed to run the fan. Whenever the temperature will reach the 60 degree, at the time the motor will reduce the speed and it will run with the 30% of the motor speed. It is easily controlled by VFT drive. Through the input from temperature sensor, I just connected to the VFT drive. When the temperature will reach the 80 degree, sensor will give command to VFT and VFT will give full speed to rotate the motor speed and fan also will be increased. Similarly, it reached 60 degree, temperature will give command to the VFT and VFT will give command to reduce the speed of the motor, so fan speed also will be reduced. Like this way, VFT we are used in the industry. And other than that, more conveyor system and food processing area and drinking plant, all these areas mostly we are using the VFT for controlling the speed of the motors. Now we will see the advantages of VFT. Using the VFT drive, we can save the energy while reducing the starting current. So starting current will be reduced, means power consumption also reduced, so energy will be saving. Second is power factor improvement. Power factor means here we are using the capacitor, so capacitor automatically will increase the real power, so power factor also improved. Smooth starting. So while starting time and stopping time also we can easily control the motor speed. So starting current is reduced, so we can easily achieve the smooth starting. reduce power when it is not required. That is the one of the example for that cooling fan. When the temperature, if it is 60 degree, means if the VFT is controlling the speed to the 30%, so the power consumption for the motor will be reduced to 30%. That is here mentioned. So we can reduce the power when it is not required. Then easily reversal of motor. For reversing operation, we can just give the command to change the rotation of the motor without changing the cable connections. In controlled start and stop and acceleration. So the overall the operation and also starting and stop, we can control the speed of the motor. And VFD also having the different type of protection like short circuit, overload, earth leakage and phase loss. These are the additional protection given in the VFD drives. So these are the advantages of the VFD, and this is the VFD complete discussion. I hope you will understand what is VFD, how VFD is working, and how the black diagram of VFD is working, and how the VFD in plant we are using. If you really like this video, give a thumbs up and share this video to your friend circle, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.